Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Space Ninja. As always, I am D, and like I told you guys last time, we're going to move on to the void. Although before we do that, I am going to point out that I did actually open up Ceres, so I could probably what I'll end up doing is I'll do a mission on Ceres after we go to the void. I'm doing this with Atlas, because I'll do this one with Atlas, I'll do the first one on Ceres with Mag. Although with Mag, what I'm gonna end up doing is a melee only run. Find a mod.
The tower's neural sentry is operational. I'm picking up multiple threats, all under Orican control. Wipe all out.
Done. I love the Tigris Prime. Aside from my bows, this is easily becoming my favorite weapon.
The tower's newest sentry has turned these soldiers into mindless attack drones. You need to take them out.
Oh yeah, okay, let's not stand on something called a death orb. Probably not my brightest moment. Man, those guys did a number on this place. Shield back. Where's the heavy gunner? Also, one thing I did do off camera is let me show you something real quick. I did find a style mod for my Dex Dacra, the swirling tiger stance. Fanning multi-hit strikes. I did also go ahead and upgrade it all the way so that I can do all the combos. That's probably what I'm gonna use when I go for my melee only run with Mag on Ceres. I'm sorry, I didn't hear you over the sound of you being separated. Also, rumblers. This one had no option for, actually I probably did have an option for stealth on this, I just decided to go in loud. I forgot I could do that. Take down their shield drones. Send his body flying 1,000 feet with a shotgun blast. Cephalon fragment. Stop doing that, please. Okay, really, what are you expecting to do with that? Annoy me? Because you kinda did. Mod. Also, I think I mentioned this in the description at least, but I found out what I was doing wrong about the whole Azima magazine firing off. It's actually the secondary fire. I thought I just did it after you ran out of ammo in the primary fire. But here, allow me to demonstrate by doing this. And messing that up horribly. Here. Basically what it does is it fires off the magazine, and the magazine sits in one place as a kind of a single, as a kind of a temporary turret. The cool thing is, it goes until it runs out of ammo. And it has as much ammo as the magazine does when you fire it off like that, so. In my case, anytime I do that from a full clip, mine is going to have 83 shots. You know, you gotta realize there are multiple paths for me to take to kill you guys. Also, if you notice, my swords are a little different than they looked. They also have dual combo damages. I think it's doing magnetic and the combination of toxic damage and fire damage, which I think is gas. Okay, the fact that my shotgun can kill you guys from up here, this thing is a little absurd. Not that I'm complaining, I love this thing. Also, let's just do this for fun. Meteor drop! Would have been really cool if I hit somebody, but that was an Eximus. Thank you, idiots, for being kind enough to give me time to reload this thing. Oh, that was an ancient I was hearing. I was like, what is that noise? Bye. Oh, yeah, you guys can do shockwaves too. I forgot. Buddies. Stop that. Where is this thing and where is it shooting me from? Oh, it's up there. Why did that turn red? I'm actually out of ammo. I think I mentioned before, but I hate MOA. Actually, you know what? Let's switch to the Azima for a little bit. And pray for some shotgun ammo. Okay, what the? Oh wow, that thing can actually kind of come up inside somebody. That's funny. And mildly terrifying. Turret. 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 Okay, I am down literally to my abilities and my swords at this point. Okay, I've got pistol ammo back. Let the rumblers go to town for a little bit. An argon crystal, finally! I've been looking for one of those for a long time. And are you honestly just staring at the wall? Sheesh. Even corrupted by the Orokin, these guys are just complete idiots. Stuff! Ow! That was stupid. Oh, laser hallways. Well, I did just get some shotgun ammo, so... I'm pretty sure I sliced his head off from the crotch up. Kinda liking the tiger style. Slashy. Oh. Ooh. Some ferrite. Rubido, I can use some of that. I'm just really glad I got that argon crystal. We're done here. I need to go before we go onto the mission with Mag. I'm gonna see what I need to finish the incubator power core, because that's what I've been working for this whole time. I'm still working on that goddamn Kubrow. Ammo case. Oh, it's for a carrier. Hmm. That could have gone a lot worse. Excuse me. First off, though, we're going to switch over to Mag and then unequip. Mag does technically have less power, health, and armor, but her shields are stronger. But yeah, let's see. Upgrade for the Dextacra. Yeah, because I've got Shocking Touch, North Wind, Molten Impact, and Fever Strike. So I'm doing gas, 93.6 gas damage and 156 magnetic damage. I need to go and upgrade Fever Strike, actually. We'll do that before we leave as well. Let's see. I need to go to the foundry, which is over here. Miscellaneous. Okay, I just need quite a lot more nanospores. first. Pure Strike Fusion. How much endo? 620 out of my 800. That's a lot of my endo, but let's look at Molten Impact. Can I upgrade that at all? I could, but I don't have the endo for it. Oh well. Alright, that actually means I do a ton more damage. Anyway, on to Ceres. It's another extermination mission, yes, but... And it's also level 12 to 14, whereas Mag is 30. But hey. Five kills while sliding. Okay, the cape thing is... And that right there is why I decided to put a cape on any of my... on all of the warframes I have that hit level 30. It's actually got an official name. It's a Xiandana or something like that. I don't know how to pronounce it properly, so... Okay, it's the assembly plant laser. Let's avoid it because that'll probably hurt like hell. This probably won't take quite as long as the last one. Let's take a look at the combos real quick. Basic one, two, pause, four more, two, hold, two more. I'm gonna try that last one. That's the basic combo. I think that's the actual pause combo, but either way. The funny thing is about the melee system, I'm not sure how actually useful the combos are. Although I say that and then I just cut my way through three enemies without even noticing. Yes, please hit your jetpack and then fly away and die at the same time. No kidding. What are you? Guardsman. Yoink! You're a sniper, you don't come within 3 feet of me. If you hear some noise in the background, sounds a little like thunder, it's somebody with a cart out in the hallway. Say goodbye to your face. He must have run into a laser because I didn't see that guy, and I don't leave people alive. The Grineer really need to rethink their training. I just cut that guy through a wall and a window. Arctic XMSA. Well, luckily that's actually not as big a problem for me as it would be, because I'm not using guns. Game seems a little glitchy today. Oh. I was gonna say, you know what? I know something that does go through walls. Let's get on the conveyor belt, because why not? Float away. Oh, cool, it actually does work. Because I've seen some games where, like, you get on a conveyor belt and it's just a... it's just a texture. It doesn't actually have any physics interaction. I mean, the guys behind this know their stuff. So I'd kind of expect them to do more than just a moving texture. Well, that worked out a little better for me than it did for them. Where exactly are you? There's a lot of guys over there. There you are. Yeesh. Unfortunately, Affinity is actually worthless as mag, I think. I don't know if... I'm not sure if getting an Affinity pickup like that at max level affects the mastery. Like, the rank up mastery, I mean. Okay, these swords cut straight through a barricade and the guy behind it. I'm starting to feel like guts. Oh, one of you bastards. Die. Oh wait, you did. Okay, one attack straight through a group of four, and all of them fell to pieces. I mean, I know that this is my highest level sword, my highest level melee weapon, and my highest level frame, but... I could ride the elevator, but come on, I'm a space... I guess I have to ride the elevator. I was gonna say, I'm a space ninja. Oh. I think it was just because I was trying to go up the one that was pouring water. Which, to be fair, not my brightest idea. Not the worst idea I've had in this series either, so... I mean, I walked right up to you. Death leap! Almost. One enemy left. Goodbye.
Another job well executed.
Let's actually take a look at the Master Rank before we end this episode. I still need to get a thing for that. Let's see, show profile. 3,461. Also, off camera, I kind of wish I'd been recording this, but off camera, I did actually have an encounter with the Stalker. It went poorly. Anyway, folks, that is this episode done. If you enjoyed, please leave a like or favorite the video. You can also leave a comment down below if you have something you'd like to say. And if you want to keep up with me, never miss any of my current series, including the new one that I just showed off yesterday. Please remember to click the subscribe button down below, or there's the icon at the end of the video. As for that, folks, I have been D. We're so close to the Kubrow. So good night, and good gaming.